He's known as Cool Hand Luke. And he and his gang of Arizona Wildcats have headed east. They shoot from all angles, brash, young, and fearless, with size and a cold steel determination to win, to outduel the ACC's best. But this is Duke's hometown, where a reputation has been built on ability and is guarded with pride. Challengers beware, the Blue Devils trigger quick speed, the power inside, and the cunning of Coach K. Today, the corral is Cameron, and the shootout is next. And this is Cameron Indoor Stadium, a basketball celebration on game day. Duke started the week ranked number three in America. Arizona now 19-5 is rising fast. In fact, some Pac-10 coaches feel this young Arizona team could be the best yet, better than the Final Four team of 2 years ago. I'm joined by Coach Al McGuire. Al, your friend Lute Olson wants tough road games to get ready for the tournament. This is a tough road game.
Well, they also want to become mentally tough. Here, Don, since 1982-83 season, no non-conference team has won. That's 55 in a row. So if they get out here with a win, it's big. That means they're a Final Four team.
They had a sensational game a year ago. Arizona beat Duke by 2 points. Duke wants to avenge that loss today. What kind of a game will it be, Al?
I think the winner will be the team that hits from three-point land, but it's going to be a physical game. AU's one of the most physical teams in the land. There'll be bodies flying around. It will be war on the boards.
We'll be ready for the Duke Blue Devils and the Arizona Wildcats. The starting lineups and the tip-off in a moment.
It's Tuesday afternoon in Ford County.
Darnest thing about life here in Ford County. You'd think with a name like Ford County, people would prefer Ford trucks. Au contraire, people from Ford prefer Chevy trucks.
Always said we were on the cutting edge.
Isn't that the darndest thing?
Could it be we're the bellwether of major societal shifts?
It's mind-boggling.
Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Because you like Sundays to be all downhill.
It's the right beer now.
If you're the type who will go to the mat for a good time.
It's the right beer now.
Because out here, not everything hibernates for the winter. So reach for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Coors Light. Yeah, it's the right beer now.
Heard from an old student. Remember Brian McKenna? Smart kid.
Good ball player. Great hands.
Where's he going to college?
He's not.
Oh, too bad.
Studying aviation electronics.
But you said
in the Navy, then college.
The Navy College Fund. $25,000 for your college education. Today's high-tech Navy.
You and the Navy.
Like I said, smart kid.
Full speed ahead.
Hold it. Ho, ho, ho.
So you're going to finally meet Cindy, huh?
Tonight.
Good. So, first impressions are very important.
I think.
Okay. Now, imagine. Lights are low, the music's soft. Knock the door, opens up, and somebody's out there doing this.
What is this? She's got dandruff?
No, you have dandruff.
No!
Yes, you do.
I shampoo every day.
You can shampoo your brains out with regular shampoo. It wouldn't matter.
Your brains out?
Yeah, well, so use that.
Head and Shoulders?
Works for me, my friend.
But you don't have dandruff.
Exactamundo!
Head and Shoulders. Because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
We're back and set to go at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Arizona starting the week number 21, but a couple of big road wins have really buoyed this team. Brian Williams, a transfer from Maryland, starts at one forward. Judd Bushler is the team leader. At center, a true freshman, Ed Stokes, coming on fast. And in the backcourt, a couple of terrific outside shooters, Matt Muehlbach and Matt Offick. And there's the head man, Cool Hand Lute Olson. Now in his seventh season as head coach of the Wildcats, his team was number one in America at the end of the last regular season, lost in the round of 16 the year before they went to the Final Four. Duke will start senior Robert Bricky at one forward and the standout sophomore Christian Leitner at the other. Ala Abdelnaby, a big senior, is having his best season so far. In the backcourt is senior Phil Henderson, a scorer, and the quarterback, the freshman Bobby Hurley, who's on his way to an all-time Duke assist record. And the head man, Coach Mike Krzyzewski, in his 10th season, looking for his team to get back in winning form after losing on Thursday night at North Carolina State. Duke in white. Tip is controlled by the Wildcats of Arizona. Offic in the back line. These guys can fire from 25, these two outside shooters. Offic three down low. Posts up on Hurley and gets the roll, and Arizona takes a two-point lead.
Simple crisscross off a high post pick. Left Offic three underneath.
Bricky's shot doesn't go. Robert Bricky contests his own rebound. It's picked up by Henderson. The dish is to Abdelnaby, blocked by Ed Stokes, but there'll be a foul call on the freshman.
It's going to be a physical ball game, Don. You'll notice the referees will blow real early in this to keep control. I look for both baselines to be in foul trouble going into the final 3 minutes of the game.
Abdelnaby, as you see, coming off a career game, 32 points against North Carolina State Thursday night. Really lit it up in the second half, but they could not catch the Wolfpack. Duke comes in with a 22-5 record, 9-3 in the ACC. Getting set for a showdown game with Clemson, the other co-leader.
Pressure up court.
Neubach, the outside shooter, hawked by Henderson. Duke really digs in on defense and make you work for everything.
Why they dig this hard is that forces the baseline higher, out of position.
Offic with the left-hand stroke. He hits it. These guys had absolutely phenomenal shooting against Cal the other night. They hit 67% at Arizona as a team, hit 9 of 15 three-pointers, and they were almost as hot against Stanford on Friday night. Hit 7 of 9 three-pointers in that game. Down low, Duke gets one, and it's a 5-4 game.
Attacked the 2-3 zone perfectly that time. Hit in the middle and dish out to the right side. Hard man-to-man by Duke.
Steal by Henderson. The ball tipped away. It'll come back inbounds to Arizona. Robert Bricky was the last to touch it. The co-players of the year in college basketball came from these two schools. Lute Olson, of course, had Sean Elliott last year, the Kodak player of the year. And Danny Ferry was the key man for Mike Krzyzewski at Duke. And even without these two great players who've gone on to the pros, Ferry in Italy, Elliott in the NBA, these two teams could go a long way. A lot of people think they could really get to Denver.
There's an outside chance. One of them will, both won't. But you got to remember, the personnel changes, the coaches don't. As long as Lute Olson and Mike Krzyzewski stay, they'll have up programs.
Hurley with the steal, driving on Offic, and Bobby Hurley doesn't get the roll, and it's saved by Muehlbach, so a breakaway doesn't work for Duke, and here comes Arizona on the run.
You young people out there, Bobby Hurley killed his dribble too soon, penetrated in the air too soon. He had a shoot on the way down.
Abdelnaby steals the ball inside, throws it to Bricky, who wasn't looking for it. It's picked up by Offic, and here's a foul call on Williams as Hurley positioned himself to take a charge.
No, I think you're going to call a foul the other way, Don. I could be wrong. You're right. You're right, Don.
Bobby Hurley takes one for the team as big Brian Williams runs him over.
Brian Williams will play a tough game today because he's thinking back to the days when he was a freshman at Maryland 2 years ago, got Rookie of the Year in the ACC, and right there is where he threw Bob Hurley to the ground.
Duke, as you pointed out, Al, has not lost to a non-ACC opponent in 7 years.
When he did lose, it was to Louisville in 1982-83. 55 straight non-conference games here at Cameron. They're 55-0.
Brian Williams, though, the big man for Arizona, knows what it feels like to win here. He had a standout game when he was at Maryland as a freshman. They won here at Cameron. And he sat out last year after transferring to Arizona.
Start to find his game now, Don. He was operated on this summer for a stress fracture in his ankle.
Leitner, whose range is improving, going outside. call goes on senior Robert Bricky, who missed 9 games with a knee strain. Coach K not getting the home court call, as though he feels.
Watch, Bricky goes up. Bricky felt the guy backed up underneath him here. Good call. Let's take another angle at this one. There goes Bricky up. There's a guy back underneath him. No, he just came down with his position. That was Judd Butchlaw.
Sean Rooks is now in the game. Pete Gaudette, the chief scout for Duke, says Arizona, when they come in off the bench, gets bigger. They really have a lot of size. And now a travel call as the Wildcats are misfiring at their offensive end. And Coach Olson, who sees his team completing a 4-game, 7,000-mile road trip today, with maybe its toughest game yet, although it was pretty tough last week at UNLV.
Yeah, they blew that game to UNLV, or UNLV beat them, and then they ended up beating Cal and Stanford on the coast.
Arizona is 13-3 in the Pac-10. Henderson coming off the pick, swings out to the perimeter and spikes the three. It's a 6-5 game. 4 points for Henderson now.
They want to get the ball down to Rook.
Sean Rooks was almost traveling, but he gets the slam and Arizona goes back in front.
His whole offense is in tight down in the paint, but he can score down low.
Ryan Williams tips it away. Offic leads down low to Williams, 6'11 from Santa Monica. Working hard. Look at this guy.
That was a pro play. He come to play today. Well, he wants this game. He wants to show the people at the back of the road that was no fluke that I was Rookie of the Year in the ACC at Maryland. This one dances around, doesn't go in. Now he says, forget that. I'm going to dunk it.
Let's get the Wildcats up off the bench and gives Arizona a 9-6 lead. Ryan Williams' dad was one of the original platters of the singing group of fame. Heavenly shades of night are falling. 16 to go in the first half, and Arizona by 4.
There's a motor oil that talks about world-class protection. Catchy phrase, but Valvoline is recommended by name in the owner's manuals of these world-class cars. The other motor oil is not. Whatever you drive, Valvoline makes the highest quality motor oil recommended by any car manufacturer. Around the world, people who know use Valvoline.
Ever since my brother Tom got this Magnavox 52-inch big screen TV...
The show's gonna start, come on.
He stopped going to the movies. The picture is huge, sharp, and brighter than any ordinary TV.
And I get great seats.
Plus, Magnavox has a 100-watt JBL sound system. It's the same Dolby surround sound you hear at the movies.
Yeah, and I don't have to stand in line in the rain anymore.
Tom, it doesn't always rain when you go to the movies.
Not anymore.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
They are Bugle Boy jeans.
Thank you.
College basketball is brought to you by Today's Truck Chevrolet. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. By Coors Light, the one that won't slow you down. The silver bullet is the right beer now. By Valvoline Motor Oil. People who know use Valvoline. And by Head & Shoulders, because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
Dale McGuire, this is Don Cricky back at Duke. Let's go quickly to our sideline reporter, Steve Jones. Steve?
All right, Don, even though it's been an NBA-type week for the Arizona Wildcats, the young players were right. They do not feel as though the long trip is going to affect them at all. It's only going to affect me as I get pushed off the court. The coaches are the ones that have been most affected, but Arizona's off to a good start this afternoon.
Steve, that was Wirtz, referee, pushing you. Go outside now and take 2 foul shots.
Bricky can't get his shot to go, and Abdel-Nabi loses the rebound. And so Arizona gets back the ball. Hurley keeps constant pressure on the ball. Point man on the man defense.
Yeah, he plays hard ball defense, trying to force that baseline out higher of Arizona. But they can't set up low, especially Rooks. How high they got Rooks now, and Williams. They are truly twin towers.
Tapped out, and here comes Henderson on a breakaway, defended by Muehlbach, and there's a foul call on Matt Muehlbach.
Not a bad foul that time, Don. Otherwise, it would have been a simple two down the other end. Here comes the rebound. Allen gets his hands on it. There's the foul. There's nobody protecting backcourt. 2-3 zone, Juve.
Hurley dishing down to the big man, Abdelnaby, who lays it up and in, and Duke is back to within two with 15:05 to play in the first half. Four for Abdelnaby. One of the concerns, Al, of Coach K was that his Duke team was not using enough passes when they're running their offense. They weren't working to get the good shot. They were impatient, putting it up too quickly. And their half-court game.
Well, they've got to have more balance and get ready for the conference tournament and get ready for the big dance in March.
Leitner, a tenacious rebounder, keeps going after the ball, and he gets it. Now he comes down to the offensive end, and the rebound is off the hands of Abdelnaby. It'll come inbounds to Arizona.
Bob Hurley that time created a turnover. One of the reporters asked me before the game, what do you think of Bob Hurley having so many turnovers? I said, it's good for a freshman to have them and don't break them. Sometimes you take a spirited player and you take away what makes him. He gambles on passing. As maturity comes into Bob Hurley's life, he'll complete more and more of those passes. And an assist is supposed to be a thing that ends up in a basket. Sometimes I worry about some of these assists that the statisticians give to the home teams. Tough defense, man-to-man.
Hurley comes in with 212 assists, the Duke single season record set by Amaker's 241. He'll smash that at his present rate.
Now here's a rare one. We get a picture of this. Bobby Hurley at 6 foot knocks down Bushler, who's a heavyweight. This is truly Buster Douglas going down. And there's Bobby Hurley. Up, finally get down this fanny. This is about 180 pounds difference. Oh, he really hit him. Good camera work.
Hurley's dad and mom are here today. His dad, Bob Hurley Sr., coached St. Anthony's and Bobby Hurley to the National High School Championship a year ago. St. Anthony's at Jersey City, New Jersey. Now Duke comes down looking to either tie it or go ahead. Down by two, Leitner heads to the basket.
That's a walk.
Yep, they get him on a travel as he lost his footing. Coach K, the ultimate preparer, he leaves nothing to chance. He'll have three separate meetings with his team the day before the game. They meet in the morning, again in the afternoon, then in the evening. Tape sessions, practice sessions. Luck favors the prepared team, in the opinion of Coach K, and his one-loss record indicates that that works out, as his team right now looking to go to his 23rd win of the season. Abdelnaby comes back in, and Palmer is now in the game for Duke, who doesn't get that much playing time.
Well, what Mike is trying to do, as I told you earlier, is going to be foul trouble on the baseline of both teams going into prime time at the end of the game. He's trying to shotgun the fouls.
Bushler can't get the shot, but look at Rook's muscle.
You can't allow Rooks to touch the ball in tight. He's one of the better in tight offensive scorers in college today. A little more patience against his own here. Get it to Henderson.
And Henderson heads to the hoop. Rebound tapped out. Here comes Judd Bushler kicking it out to Opik. On the left flank is Muehlbach. Lead goes to Bushler, and they're going to call a jump ball.
Arrow favors Duke.
Hurley backs away from nobody. Smallest guy on the court going after everybody out there.
It looks to me like the floor is getting humidity in here and they're starting to slip. That's the second time, one on both ends. Call the jump ball, good call. Arrow favored Duke.
And
what Arizona would have been if they had Chris Mills. They thought they had him, the transfer from Kentucky. He will not enter the stage till next year.
Arizona has led from the outset. Hurley strokes a three. It doesn't go. Rebound comes down to Boosler, the 6'6 senior. Muehlbach kicks it out to Offic. Rebound down to Stokes, inside against Palmer. And Stokes gets the roll, and the Arizona Wildcats on the road extend their lead over favored Duke to 14-8.
Stokes, as you said earlier, is a true freshman, goes around 6'11. He starts bulking up. He'll be tough to contain in his junior and senior year.
Brian Davis in the game now as Duke works against a zone defense of Arizona. Hurley penetrating and dishing to Abdelnaby, heading to the hoop. Arizona contesting hard for the loose balls, and they're going to root it off Muehlbach.
That was a close call. Could have went either way.
It's interesting. Yeah, one of Coach K's concerns was, he said, when they shoot too fast, his team on offense, it just wears them out because they play such a tough, digging defense that they're back on defense right away again.
Well, defense is there every day. Offense, you never know. It's like the stock market. You don't know where it's going. Defense is like water. It finds its level. So is rebounding like that. You rebound every day.
Duke with some errant shooting early in the game. The Blue Devils on their home floor are 3-for-12. Made only one of their last seven, only trailed by six. Ryan Davis rejected by Stokes. Muehlbach searching out the open man, sees that Duke is back on defense, goes to Boosler. Shot didn't go, but he'll hit the line to try two.
That was a poor foul. The odds are he wouldn't make that shot from that angle, and especially on his way down. Watch it. He was off on an angle from basket. Now he's up. Now he starts on his way down. Tough shot to make. Don't foul in that situation.
Both these clubs, very good free throw shooting team. Boosler has yet to score today, but he leads Arizona in scoring with an average of 15 a game.
Don, what does Duke shoot as a team? They're outstanding.
They're phenomenal. They're 76% free throw shooting team.
Well, that must be one of the best in the country.
Yeah, they're one of the top six in the country.
It only takes one guy to pull you down.
All their starters are 70% or higher. All of a sudden, Arizona's opened up an 8-point lead over favored Duke.
It's Monday morning in Ford County.
That full-size Chevy pickup sure has a more advanced design than Ford.
Now that you mention it, the lines do remind me of modern neoclassic sculpture.
I see a lot of Bauhaus influence.
The understated simplicity even contributes to greater fuel efficiency.
Form follows function.
High fuel efficiency. No wonder people from Ford prefer Chevy trucks. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
In baseball, if you traded today, you're playing somewhere else tomorrow. I know. I played for the Twins, the Rangers, the Angels, and then some. And when you've got to move fast, you can't worry about selling your house. I let the Century 21 people worry about that. I trust them. And nobody works harder to get the job done. Hey, I love Century 21.
Hey, Bert.
Uh-oh.
You got a second?
I just wish I wasn't such a good customer.
Barbasol gel gives you a super close shave like the other gel, but at a great Barbasol price.
Your Barbasol gel, sir. Your change, sir.
Barbasol gel. No wonder it appeals to the rich.
Mom, we need more Wheaties.
Right now, get Michael Jordan posters free on boxes of Wheaties. Collect all three and turn them into one jumbo Jordan poster. But you better hurry, because they're going fast. Better get your posters. Better eat your Wheaties.
Next Saturday, it's a high-stakes showdown as Big 8 Player of the Year candidate Doug Smith leads the top-ranked Missouri Tigers against the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame.
Brian Williams, a 6'11 sophomore, sat out last year, but as a freshman, he had one of his best days when he played for Maryland. He led the Terrapins over the Duke Blue Devils here at Cameron. said he changed from Maryland because he had a difference in philosophy with Coach Bob Wade, then the coach of Maryland. He said it wasn't Socrates we were talking about. It was their approach to basketball. He'd rather play for Lute Olson. Transferred and sat out the year. Henderson can't get it to go, but the tip-in comes from Brian Davis coming from off the play.
Brian Davis is very quick body. Gets off the floor fast. Trying to pound the ball down low.
Very young Arizona team. 9 of the 13 Arizona players are either freshmen or sophomores. Yet they're 19-5 and getting better fast. Rebound to Leitner, the defensive end. Out to Henderson as Hurley's out of the game now. Davis with a 12-foot pull-up. And Duke is back to within four.
Davis can certainly turn him on. He's got his break earlier in the season when Bricky went down for 8 games with a knee injury.
Dribbling violation is called on Buechler, and Coach Olson all of a sudden sees his Arizona team. After going on an 11-2 run, starts to turn it over to Duke.
Well, just a minute ago, the score was 16-8. They score now. It's only a 2-point spread.
The rebound goes to Buechler. Up court it comes to Muehlbach. They want to get it to Rooks, but he's defended well by Leitner down low.
Leitner's fronting him. It's the only way he can stop him. He can help from the weak side.
10:25 to play in the first half. It's a 16-12 Arizona lead. Follow-up shot is good by Ed Stokes.
The reason that Stokes scored, they doubled down on Rooks. Rooks missed a shot. Stokes is all by himself on the weak side of the basket.
Davis taking it into his own hands. And Brian Davis up the dribble. Hits the left-hand jumper.
He's a dependable role player, but I think he has more offensive ability. Coach K always says, we got you to play defense.
Rooks down low. Leitner out rebounds, and here comes Henderson, 2-on-2 break. Lead goes to Davis, driving hard. And the rebound is down to Stokes, but there's a foul call inside against the Wildcat.
Take a look here at Rooks. Here they're playing in front of him. Alvin Abbey's playing in front of him. Now the man comes over. Leitner comes over, which automatically leaves the weak side open. Stokes, the young freshman, a putback.
Officials today are Lenny Wirtz, John Morrow, and Jim Wright. 18-14 game. Arizona with the lead and the ball.
Lenny Wirtz has been around a long time. He'll govern the show as a referee.
Last year in the Meadowlands of New Jersey, it was Arizona beating Duke 77-75. Williams' shot doesn't go. Another rebound for Leitner. Ricky out to Henderson. It's a 2-point attempt, and it's good. 6 for Henderson. Arizona's lead down to a deuce. Williams with that excellent left-hand touch.
Trying to stop the ball from going down low. Duke is not doing too good of a job of it.
Williams comes in, as you know, Al, averaging just under 11 a game, 10.8. He has 5 so far today.
Williams is due for a lights-out game. That means he's due for a bust-out. He's due for a big one. I don't know if it'll be today, but the way he's playing, it could be today.
Now Duke again comes back to within two. Robert Ricky getting the last field goal to bring Duke to a 20-18 deficit. In and out. Buechler puts it back up, and he was fouled and goes to the line.
Allah's a little bit upset with himself committing that foul. He's come a long way since a freshman. A lot of confidence. Has unbelievable field goal shooting percentage. We're starting to call him Alamatic.
That was his second foul. Duke's game plan is to extend Arizona as hard as they can for 40 minutes. They think that the Wildcats might be running close to empty after playing this, their fourth game on a 7,000-mile road trip that began last week at UNLV. And up to Berkeley to play Cal. And here is Brian Williams following it up with a slam to give the Wildcats a 5-point lead. And that breakout game you're talking about, Al, could be developing. Williams now has 7 points.
Yeah, I think he's starting to feel good about himself. He really sat out a year and a half, didn't play much ball at all.
He coming inbound to Duke. Sean Elliott told me last year at the Kodak Awards at the Downtown Athletic Club in New York, where he got the Player of the Year award, that Ryan Williams is the best big man he'd ever played with or against, and he toured in Europe with David Robinson. He said he absolutely dominated every scrimmage. He could practice with the Arizona team last year, but he couldn't play. He said he absolutely dominated every practice.
He's up and down. What he needs is consistency.
If you feel life's more interesting when you make a splash,
it's the right beer now.
If you feel a great beer starts with great water,
it's the right beer now.
Because you're the kind of person who likes to get to the bottom of things, call for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Coors Light, it's the right beer now.
Mark and Rennie and little Lindsay are a young family just starting out. They don't have a lot of money for life insurance. I'm their State Farm agent, Gaylord Moosman. Instead of giving Mark and Rennie a big life insurance sales talk, I did a lot of listening. And we came up with a plan that's going to work for their budget and little Lindsay's future, too. State Farm agents are good listeners because we want you to have life insurance you can live with.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
A kiss?
No, right now.
You really don't want to kiss me.
Dangerous. Very dangerous.
Give me a minute, honey.
Don't let morning breath ruin a good morning. Get Scope. Scope has two powerful ingredients to kill 90% of the bacteria that cause morning breath.
Didn't I hear something about a kiss?
Right here. Right now.
Kiss me.
It is time for a kiss.
Scope. The best thing, first thing in the morning.
Hey, you. Put that kiss right here.
It's coming. The stars. The events. On April 7th, NBC Sports will unveil a unique showcase of sports programming. The Saturday Sports Showcase. Saturday afternoons will never be the same.
Lou Dalton has 8 grandchildren. He's trying to build up frequent flyer miles. The last 7 days, he went up to UNLV and returned. Then he went to the Bay Area and played Stanford in California. Then he flew all the way over here to Durham today, then has to fly back. Those frequent flyer miles, those grandchildren will be with him in Hawaii.
Lou Dalton feels very good about this ball club. He really didn't think they're going to be this good, and it's the best shooting team he's probably ever had right now. Bobby Hurley with a 3-point try. He knocks it down. And he brings Duke back to within two.
Duke needed that against the zone. That'll make that zone much weaker. Now they got to counter some way this ball going inside. Not only is Arizona big inside, they're heavy.
Rooks triple teamed. He gets it off to Wayne Womack inside, and he'll go to the line. Wayne Womack in the game, a sophomore from Pasadena, California. Lots of big people come in as Abdel Nabi now has 3.
Yeah, he'll come out and sit down for a while, which will give Duke a different face. They'll probably try to put pressure up court now. Here he comes out, putting in Davis. Davis is around 6'6", I think, Don. Active body. He plays about 6'8".
2 shots.
Womack, an 8-point-a-game scorer. And he gives Arizona a 3-point lead, 24-21. Leitner with his 5th rebound of this game.
Here we go to our first zone by U of A, our first man-to-man. They're playing man-to-man. Drifting off down low, but it's a matchup. That's because Hurley hit that 3-pointer.
Williams rebounding.
Alley-oop down to Womack. Lost the handle.
Duke will inbound the ball. Phil Henderson will bring it in from the backcourt as the Arizona Wildcats have succeeded in slowing the pace of the game. Duke wanted to run him for 40 minutes if they could get the jump on him. Arizona shot so well early, they were just taking it in from out of bounds with their possessions, too.
Trying to get Pricky into the game.
And Leitnerell, he's yet to score. Ryan Davis heads to the hoop.
Ooh, that was a close call, but Wirtz is a good official. Oh, you got him up, see? That was a close one. I don't know if that ball is reaching zenith, its apex. Let's see if the ball's on its way up. Can't catch. I'm blinded by the backboard. I'm blinded by the window, the glass.
Yeah, the 2 points on the goaltend gives Brian Davis 6 points. Leads Duke in scoring. 1 point game, Arizona. 6 minutes and 35 seconds to play. Don Quickie with Al McGuire and Steve Jones at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Rebound down to Davis. Off to Hurley. Searching out the open man. He leads to Bricky. Senior Robert Bricky turns it around for the first time. Duke takes the lead 25-24.
Once you get Bricky out of the gate, he's their leader. They could have won it all last year if he didn't go down in the semifinal game out there in Seattle.
Ryan Davis playing over the rim today.
He's just muscling up, physical, going up there, just all muscle and strength. No jerking around. He doesn't have any chance of the thing spinning out. He's getting it down low. NC, no contest. Leighton leans on him a little bit, but Leighton's body's too slim for Williams. Watch him. Lean on him a little bit. Doesn't even feel him.
Only Leitner's first foul. He's yet to score in the game, though, Christian Leitner. Not scoring the game is the man at the line, Brian Williams. He has 9 points. But misses that. Rebound to Williams. Rebounding by the numbers. Those big elbows out. Clear out. And they do as Arizona comes down the run. Here is Offit.
Don, they'll back up again and get Williams down low. Going with Rooks. There you are.
Rebound off to Henderson. I think Arizona does about as good a job, Al, getting the ball down low against Duke as any team we've seen.
So far.
Throwing it, Ryan Davis off the baseline, and Coach K sees his Blue Devils take a one-point lead.
Funny thing about Davis out there, when Bricky went down, Kubek come in. When Kubek come in, Davis got some play time, and he knocked out Kubek from play. So it was two down. We thought Kubek could get more play. They ended up giving exposure to Davis, and obviously, you can see what Davis is doing out there right now.
Second foul on Hurley. He comes out. Another freshman, McCaffrey, comes in. 5:18 to go in the first half.
McCaffrey's good. Can't run the show at the authority of Bobby Hurley. Needs a little bit more strength, a little bit more playing time. That will come in the next couple of years.
Arizona, number 12, Matt Offit.
But he can bomb them from outside.
Here's Offit at the free throw line. He has 5 points today.
He's that Las Vegas connection. Him and Brian Williams out of Las Vegas.
Yep, he's from Bishop O'Gorman High School in Las Vegas, where Tarkanian's son played, Danny.
I see where they're finally settling with the NCAA after 12, 13 years. I wonder what that means. 2-3 zone, U of A, stay with it most of the time.
Those Royals had the meter run for a while, didn't they?
They always do. Let me tell you something, Don. Always set because justice is costly.
It's better to know the judge than the law, right?
It's better never to get to court.
Inbounds goes to Offit. McCaffrey now pressuring the point.
Good ball game, just the way I figured it'd go. I thought there'd be more fouls down low.
Williams is out now. Stokes is back in. Here is Big Ed Stokes at 6'11". He was a recruiting coup. His best friend and teammate at St. Bernard's High School in California was George Raveling's son. As to the basket goes Judd Bushler. He has five.
I remember the Wildcats have only committed 3 personal fouls. That's because they're playing in the zone. You don't foul when you play in the zone. You foul mainly when you're playing man-to-man.
Leitner. Little too much on it. Rebound comes down to Womack.
Yeah, those elbows swinging.
Long lead to Bushler. He's a lot like Marley, Dan Marley, the Olympic player now, the Phoenix Suns. The Blue Devils come up with a loose ball. Henderson is 6'4". Doing a jig, but getting nothing out of it as the defense stayed right with him. And now the missed shot by Bricky does result in a foul call against Arizona.
Nice, smooth move towards the middle.
Leitner sits down. Kubek is in the game. Greg Kubek. Leitner has yet to score in a game, Al.
He'll come. Not pushing. Kubek now try one or two from three-point land for Duke. This is the guy. This is the key to whether they can go to the mile high city. Robert Bricky has a brace, something like Elliott last year. Elliott still wears it. Elliott wears a security blanket.
Robert Bricky suffered a partially torn ligament in his knee January 9th, missed nine games. But the dentist, Jesse said, it helped the team in that some younger players got much needed time and they got better fast, and now they're all back with the tournament approaching.
So your little brother's joining us, huh?
He's not so little anymore.
All right, now let's move it!
He's what, 19?
Weight setting, 540, F-14.
Jeff's landing planes?
Four gear lens set.
No. $40 million jets.
Today's Navy. High-tech training that takes you only one way. Full speed ahead.
Primary's off.
Good job, Dad. You and the
Navy. Jeff?
See? He's not so little anymore. Full speed
ahead. Saturday morning in Ford County.
I see you got a new Chevy.
Yep.
That's a pretty smart buy when you amortize the cost of depreciation as it relates to inflation in the GNP.
Yep.
In fact, when compared with Ford Ranger, Chevy S10 has held more of its value model years 1984 through 88.
Yep, and they say they've been worth more when you trade them in, too.
A tradition of higher resale value. No wonder people from Ford prefer Chevy trucks. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
Yep.
This one's going right down to the wire. Here we go.
Domino's. It's Charlie. I'll take a deluxe Pam pizza. See you in 30. Great.
Don't miss any of the action.
It's time for Domino's Pizza. Call now.
How fast does Dristan nasal spray start to work?
Faster than Dolly can pick up a $5 tip.
Dristan spray pump works fast to relieve congestion, even sinus pressure. For relief.
Faster than tumbleweed in a tornado.
Dristan nasal spray. It's faster than...
Each March, the tour's best gather on a course unlike any other. It's challenging fairways and deceptive greens mastered only by the game's great champions. Jack Nicklaus, Lee Trevino, Tom Kite. It's time for a renewal of the test. Time for the Players' Championship.
I'm here on the sideline with Bob Hurley, Sr., and you've been nervously watching this ball game. What do you look for in indicators of how Bob's playing?
Well, I'm just a nervous wreck. I'm having a hard time watching him, Steve. He's playing aggressively, and I think when we've come a couple of times, he's tried a little bit too hard, maybe. You got to relax a little bit out there.
So you're thinking about staying away? Maybe he'll play better.
I'd rather coach at home. It's a little easier than watching these games.
All right, let's go back up to Donna now. Coach Hurley has had 17 Catholic state championship teams in New Jersey over the years.
He doesn't have a home court, does he, Don?
Well, he does now. They got the Jersey City Armory. But for years, every game was a road game, even when they practiced. Lead goes down to Kubek. McCaffrey, and he can't get it. Ball comes inbounds to Arizona. That's a great story, really, to St. Anthony's. They've worked hard to keep the school open. They usually didn't know where they were going to practice, Al, until that afternoon. Coach Hurley would find an open building somewhere.
I remember once seeing something where they took the bingo tables down.
Yeah, that was at the White Eagle, the famous White Eagle Hall.
You could tell it was a Catholic school if they had bingo. that's not a good quote. Man-to-man hard by Duke, obviously. Don't have their muscle team in here right now, U of A. More a finesse team. See? All finesse.
Womack heading to the hoop is fouled by Davis. They exchange words. Second on Brian Davis. Arizona, leader by 8 earlier in the game, holding to a one-point lead at this point. 3:02 to go in the half.
Here he has on the inside. All free. He'll end up with two shot fouls. Not a one-and-one. It's a good save by Davis. Make the guy make him from 15 feet out. You only got 3 minutes left to go, and U of A has only committed 4 personal fouls as a team.
Arizona has been in the bonus, but hasn't been able to capitalize lately, still holding to the one-point lead. Womack fouled in the act of shooting, misses in both.
You need some trajectory on that foul shot, too flat.
Oklahoma up on number one Missouri. They're playing at Norman today after that great game a week ago when Missouri prevailed at Columbia, Missouri.
Oklahoma has the second longest winning streak in the country.
At home, right. They've won 45 in a row, has Arizona. But right now, Duke takes the lead, and there's a foul on the play.
You know, to be a dynasty, to be good, you must win at home. As we told you earlier, there's been a non-conference team come out of here in the last 55 games with a W. That's from 1982.
Bill Henderson bags the two-point shot and goes to the line looking to give Duke its biggest lead, which would be 2 points. Henderson has hit 4 or 5 field goals today. Duke has not had a good shooting day. He has.
Doesn't count. No basket.
Lane violation.
No basket. He lost his balance and stepped in. Could have been nudged a little bit.
Now Duke goes into a full court press that Opik will break if he can with the dribble. Moving on Hurley.
Now they got their powerhouse team in again. You're a whole weightlifting team out there. Big strong baseline with Rooks. Here go Rooks will go up.
Don Rooks can't get it to go. A tremendous play, an offensive rebound, and back up by Butchler, but it doesn't go. And Hurley back in the game leads the Duke break.
Should go up right from there.
Hill stroking. He was on the line. Doesn't go. Rooks rebounds. Outlet goes to Opik. 10 men running now. Long lead goes down to Williams. Tipped away by Thomas Hill. And here comes Hurley. Inside to Leitner. Ball tipped away. And there's a foul call on Sean Rooks.
To Leitner. That's where Rooks reached in. That's the foul. We call it a two-shot foul. Everything from now on out is one-on-one, both teams. Nice and quiet. One of their buddies is shooting.
And one of their buddies, Christian Leitner, gets his first point of the day as Duke leads by 2.
Get quiet, a little quieter.
Very consistent free throw shooter. At the conclusion of today's game, we'll be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player. From each team, Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to the general scholarship fund of each school.
See how they isolate, bringing the ball up. One man on one man, you can't turn them over. Bad lead pass, bad lead pass.
Major collision, no foul. Now a whistle stops play.
Going to be a tough call. You know why? Henderson didn't have any place to come down, but they're calling Henderson for charging. We'll watch the play. We're going to run it. Here we go. Bob kicks the ball down. There's Henderson, but he had no place to come down.
Sean Rooks go to the free throw line. Lute handling the years very well, Al. He looks like a matinee idol over there. That white hair.
Well, Wild Root Cream Oil Charlie, his hair's never out of place. He looks like a senator. Hey, one of these two guys are going to be the Olympic coach in Barcelona, Spain in 1992. And you know what? It's hard to pick which one's better. They're both good.
Well, one of the things that recommends Lute Olson is the fact he coached in the World Games in Spain the year before the Olympics, and with a lesser team than we sent to Seoul, he beat the same Soviet team that won the gold medal. And, of course, Krzyzewski's recommendations are impeccable. Coming up at halftime, An update with Bob Costas. He'll be talking to Evander Holyfield, who's getting ready for a big payday. And we'll have State Farm rules of the game. 1:23 to play in the first half. Krzyzewski will be coaching the U.S. in the Goodwill Games and in the World Games this year. Harvey Mason is in the game, playing with an injured knee. He's just working back into shape, a very important part of the Arizona team. This is Mason from the outside to Buechler. I think you said something now when you're talking about bodies on the floor. They've been on there all day.
They have the front down low, which Stukas doing. They're switching as the two big men crisscross. Too much hands on Sean Rooks that time. They put him on the foul line. One and one. Working real hard down low on D. No, they're going to put Buechler on the foul line. Excuse me.
Arizona's going to get a big shot in the arm next season when Chris Mills, a 6'7", 210-pound forward, comes back into play. He transferred from Kentucky. Sitting out this year, they say, Lou Dawson says, he's our best defensive player in our scrimmages.
Lou Olson is the miracle of the desert. Used to be UCLA. You know what's happening also, Don? Mike is getting to be the man. It all started out here with Everett Case. Then 30 years up, he stepped in, give him a shot again. They made it, they don't have it. Used to be Everett Case. Then it was Frank McGuire and Dean Smith. But for the last 4 years, Mike has been the man. Let's beat Duke.
They've been the winningest team over the last 6 years. Carolina, the winningest team over the last 10. There's a hit, and Duke comes back to take the lead as Henderson now has 10 points for the Blue Devils, and we're down to 33 seconds to play in the half.
We're down to one shot, maybe a putback off a missed shot.
Arizona led early by 8. Then there's been 6 lead changes since. Wildcats looking for the final shot of the half. Game clock is the shot clock now. It's down to 14 seconds to play. As Buechler heads in, Rooks turns, tipped up by Williams.
And there's the putback
by Williams. It goes. And that will do it. So Williams with a big first half, 11 points. A very emotional day for Williams. And underdog Arizona Wildcats go to the locker room with a 36-35 lead. Now to NBC Sports Update and to Bob Costas. Bob?
Okay, Don, you've got a good one going there. We'll get back to you in a few minutes. But coming up first, we'll be joined live here in the studio by the number one ranked heavyweight contender, Evander Holyfield. And we'll check all the scores in college basketball and the NBA. A busy day on both fronts. That's all coming up right after these commercial messages. So stay with us.
Basketball is brought to you by Pontiac and your local Pontiac dealer. We build excitement. And by Domino's Pizza. Hot, fresh, delicious pan pizza. Domino's pan pizza. Nobody delivers better.
And a wild development just before halftime. Here's Coach McGuire.
What was happening, they were down by a point, U of A, and what happened, Coach Krzyzewski thought that Williams was fouling in here against Bricky. You can tell Bricky because he has the bracer on his leg there. Now watch the play. Go ahead, now watch him move down. Williams moves it into. There's he moving in, pushing off. Right there's the foul. He doesn't make this one. Second one was all pure, which gave U of A lead going down court. Mike was very upset.
So the development was that Arizona went to the locker room taking the lead with a 36-35 advantage, and Arizona starts the second half out shooting technicals.
Well, the funny thing about it all, Don, is that halftime, Muhlenbach came out because he leads the team in foul shooting percentage at 85%, and he's practicing his foul shot.
He's out there now. This is how the second half is starting. A technical foul call on Mike Krzyzewski.
Oh!
Muhlenbach misses the first of two technical free throws. Arizona will then get possession of the ball.
You got to remember, it's more difficult to shoot a foul with nobody on the lines than it is with someone on the line. Oh, he missed both of them. Most of the time, a ball player is accustomed to having the lines filled with bodies.
The striped shirts behind the basket didn't get any help either. Now Arizona opens the second half with possession of the ball. Matt Osick to Muehlbach. Krzyzewski was absolutely enraged. He had to be held back from going after official Jim Wright. As down low, Judd Buechler puts up and in. Commissioner Gene Corrigan will be checking those tapes tomorrow. Well, over in Greensboro. No harm, no foul, though. There's a lot of shouting.
What's happening here is that U of A is one of the most physical teams. Just their bodies. They don't do anything wrong. They just play hard. The team that starts hitting from the outside will win this ball game, as I said on the top of the show. No one's hitting at the present time from outside. In that first half, the only outstanding statistic was that U of A turned the ball over 11 times.
Anderson with that last shot. And now one back at the other end, and makes it a 40-37 game.
And the ever-present 2-3 zone. It should be hot.
Anderson keeping Duke right in the ball game, tied up now 40-all as we start the second half.
Can't turn a guy over one-on-one. You get a five count, you can't turn him over. It's almost impossible. Nice back door.
Judd Buechler, a 6'6 senior from Poway, California, slamming down two to give the Arizona Wildcats the two-point lead, 11 now for Buechler.
Caught Christian Leighton a turn in his head, went back door.
Two very well-schooled teams defensively. They turn it into a half-court game. Lattner got out in the first half and still with no field goals. Down low, here's a foul on Leighton.
Leighton hasn't gotten into the ball game yet. I think it was 0-for-6 from the field in the first half. Let's go back to that back door I was just talking about before, where Christian Leighton turned his head. See, Christian turned, and there goes Judge in for automatic. Is he a competitor? Is he a man?
He's the leader, Judd Buechler.
I heard it 1,000 times, but body by Fisher.
Muehlbach goes to the free throw line. He played for Bishop O'Dowd in San Francisco as a junior, and they came within one game of the California State Championship. His dad got transferred to Kansas City, played for Rockhurst High School, and they won the Missouri State Championship behind Muehlbach.
He'll make these because there's guys on the line. Earlier with the technicals, it was tough shooting.
Make him, he does, and it's a four-point advantage now for Arizona. Lute Olson, the coach of the Wildcats, said between last Sunday and this, playing at UNLV and now Duke, we won't face anything tougher in the tournament. Hurley can't get it to go. Lead goes up court. Muehlbach on the run.
Over to Osick.
And Osick is the man, gunning the left-hander. Three-point shooting has been off. Williams muscling inside. Back up and down it goes by freshman Ed Stokes.
All muscle inside. Ed Stokes doesn't have that much muscle yet. But when Rooks comes in, then it's three John Atlases down there. Nobody's kicking sand in their face.
They got five players, 230 pounds or more, Arizona. Here's a foul call now on Muehlbach. There's the Tri-Towers, the Tucson skyline. William Stokes and Rooks.
First team foul in the second half.
This is a rising team. They started the week 21st in one poll after the loss to UNLV. And they're going to move up fast. You mentioned Mike Montgomery, the Stanford coach, says he thinks this is the best Arizona team yet. Anderson is doing the job for the Duke Blue Devils. He has 18 points, and he cuts the Arizona lead to three.
That last substitution was just for Coach K to speak to Alden Abbey and to Leitner, say, hey, get your heads in the game. You got to play physical. This is a contact sport today, especially down low.
Stokes, if he wasn't fouled, nobody's been, but there's no call. The rebound does come to Buechler. Dish off to Stokes. Ball slapped over, and here comes Henderson on the run. Buechler coming from behind, and Henderson screams away the defender with his back and lays it in with a right hand opposite side. 20 points for Henderson and a one-point lead for Arizona.
Kept his body in between himself and the defender all the way.
Duke's famous defense. They're digging in.
10 lead changes in the first half.
They're fronting on Williams down there, leaning on each other. Missed that back door, Don.
Yep, and Bricky stripped it. Robert Bricky. And they get a call against Arizona. It's a foul called on Muehlbach.
He did step in. We have a high view from where we are in the booth. He just didn't allow enough room. Watch, he didn't allow enough room. There's a step in.
What do you think?
It was a close call, like you said.
Foul trouble. Muehlbach now with four. The two big men for Duke, Abdelnaby and Leitner, each with three.
That was their biggest concern for Duke, is the foul trouble of their baseline. Get it to Henderson. Here's the hot hand. When you're on fire, blow some wind on it. Put some breeze on it. Keep it hot.
Our NBC statistician, Elliot Cal, pointing out here, Al, that Duke's 10 second-half points have all been scored by Henderson. He had 10 at the half. Now he has 20 for the game. Leitner still without a field goal, and he won't get one on that. Looks like one of mine there. .15:46 to play in the game. A one-point lead for Arizona.
Independent suspension, a powerful fuel-injected V6, and made anti-lock brakes available. Its designers blessed it with an aerodynamic profile. And now, to make Grand Prix an even better value, our accountants have added this.
Mom, we need more Wheaties!
Right now, get Michael Jordan posters free on boxes of Wheaties. Collect all three and turn them into one jumbo Jordan poster. But you better hurry, because they're going fast. Better get your posters. Better eat your Wheaties.
The people who count on my breaks are important to me. So the people who work on my breaks are important to me.
The people who work on your breaks at Midas are trained brake experts. Remember, nobody beats Midas. Nobody.
Each March, the Tour's best gather on a course unlike any other. It's challenging fairways and deceptive greens mastered only by the game's great champions. Jack Nicklaus, Lee Trevino, Tom Kite. It's time for a renewal of the test. Time for the Players' Championship.
It's tight at the top in the ACC race. Duke and Clemson, 1-1 at the moment. Here's Steve Jones.
Well, I'm over here in the student section, and they're pretty irate. I went down to the Arizona huddle, and what Lute Olson wants his team to do is be more aggressive, particularly in putting the ball back up to the basket. He feels that they can control the ball game inside.
They're putting a lot of pressure on the Arizona offense now. Hurley pressing, but Rook breaks free off a roll, and they call it on Arizona.
Robert Bricky held his ground that time. When Brooks started in, he didn't have complete control, didn't come to a complete stop, see? Caught a piece of him. Nice friendly reaction there by my man Luke.
Well, Krzyzewski had the desired effect with his halftime tirade. Not one called gun against Duke in the second half. Abdelnaby slams one down, and Duke takes the lead 47-46.
Arizona got to pump it down inside. Get those putback baskets. Wide bodies. There it is.
Williams down low. Off the glass. Leitner with good defensive position. And very agile Brian Williams pulls up, doesn't charge him, and lays it in. 13 points for Brian Williams.
And Arizona has to go to the zone to stop it.
Henderson continues to light it up for the Blue Devils as they take the lead. 49-48, Henderson with 22.
Henderson almost didn't come back to school. Left this summer and came back.
Coach K saying thank you so very much for coming back. He's 5 for 5 in the second half as Henderson.
I really think these referees should take two coaches here and put them together, talk to them. It's getting a little bit heated down there. The place is getting like a steam bath. Luke thinks he finally got a call his way and overreacted to it. Watch. That's it. About time. About time.
Okay, Arizona is to be in a game after the games they've played recently, three games in the past week, and then traveling the long way to Durham, North Carolina. And they've led at halftime, did the Wildcats. Right now they're down by one. Rooks will look to tie it up if he can hit his second of two. Don Rooks, sophomore from Fontana, California.
Potential All-American down the road. I'm not using that word loosely.
We're tied up 49-all with 14:33 to play. Our producer today for NBC Sports is Tommy Roy. Director John Gonzalez, the executive producer, Terry O'Neill. As right now, Ala Abdelnaby is hit inside by Rooks, who, as Abdelnaby tried to slam it down.
Here's a point to Bobby Hurley. An excellent pass inside. Watch the zip on the ball. Coming into Ala. Rooks tried to cut it off, but too late. Makes up with a foul. No, you can't cry in that one. Sean, you hit him all the way.
Silence is deafening when Duke shoots the free throws. Abdelnaby, a 6'10 senior from Bloomfield, New Jersey, came to America with his family when he was 2.5 years old. In 1971, he was born in Cairo, Egypt. Rebound to Rooks. Out left to Offit. Here comes the Wildcats. Up court to Buechler, and it was tipped by Davis. Arizona will inbound the ball, trailing Duke by a point.
Watch the picking down low for the big men to get inside position for putbacks.
Arizona, very, very steady, aggressive team. Very consistent under pressure. Nobody non-conference has beaten Duke here in 7 years.
Nice play by Robert Bricky.
Offit with his best play of the day. Switch hands, and then he pushes Hurley on the way up, and Hurley had something to say to him. 9 points now for Offit.
U of A's playing with one guard and four baseline men. Get it to Henderson. Get a fly, son.
Rebound to Womack. Up court to Offit. Arizona getting its running game going now. Hurley goes for the steal. Offit recovers. 13:35 to play in the game. Arizona with a one-point lead. But a throwaway, and it comes in down to the Blue Devils.
They're saying he was held. There he is. He was held. He hit his elbow.
7 years ago, Louisville beat Duke here in Cameron. That was the last non-ACC team to win here. 55 games ago. Lee Henderson with extraordinary shooting, and he continues his point for eyes.
He's not only a shooter, he's a scorer. That last shot is the toughest shot he made all day. When you're going at the rim and play it in the rim and not off the backboard, that takes grace. That takes talent.
Henderson leads all scorers in the game with 24. Here's a steal by Bricky. Tips to Hurley. 3-on-3 break. As Hurley rockets and then kicks off to Bricky. Robert Bricky can't get it to go. Bush out-muscles people for the defensive board.
You don't get many second shots off the Wildcats.
Hurley on the arm.
Too much hands on Hurley. It was a mismatch. He had to reach in. Here's a mismatch. Watch him drive center. This is about 6'6", 6'7", against 5'11", a 6-foot. He had a foul.
That's the third personal foul on Duke. There's four on Arizona. As a team.
Freshman Bill McCaffrey comes in, replacing Bobby Hurley. At the moment in the Pac-10, Arizona, which has won the conference the last 2 years with 17-1 record, stands 13-3 this year, is one game behind Oregon State. But Oregon State has to go to Arizona for the final two conference games. At Arizona State, I think, on Thursday, and then they play at Arizona on Saturday.
This Judd here, he's a jack of all trades. Has no glaring weakness in his game.
Arizona by one. Duke with the ball. 12 and a half to go in the game. Thomas Hill leads to Abdul Nabi.
Nice bounce feed with Davis.
Ball's tipped out, and there's a four-on-one break, but Womack, for some reason, pulls up. Now out to Opik, three-pointer. Brooks going for the slam, can't get it, tipped over, and here comes Brian Davis leading the break, three-on-two.
Allah, he's free, there he is.
And Allah answers as he slams it down. He has 9 points, and Duke has the lead, 54-53.
Back comes Williams into the ball game with the first dead ball.
Sean Rooks, you're talking about his inside game, Al. He really does have a strong one.
Well, he has 11 points now. Space Eater. More like an NBA baseline for Arizona.
Loop down low to Abdul Nabi. Brian Davis as Abdul Nabi rolls off the defender. Abdul Nabi starting to score. He has 11, and Duke again has the lead. Had about 18 lead changes. Oklahoma well in hand against number one Missouri at the moment in the second half.
Must be putting heat on up there in Norman. They say Billy Tubbs always puts heat in that arena.
Boosters pass. A misconnection trying to get Womack, who was going baseline. The ball turns over to Duke when we come back to Cameron.
Look out tomorrow.
I showed them ways they could update their family coverage to cover their bigger family. Like every State Farm agent, I work with a family to help keep their insurance up to date. Keeping up with the girls, that's their job.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hall of Famer Nancy Lopez, three-time champion Betsy King, and the best in ladies golf tee off at the Women's Kemper Open next weekend on NBC.
Coach Lute Olson directing his Wildcats in the heat of battle here at Duke, where his team trails by one. Here he is after they came back from the NCAA tournament last year. It was actually 2 years ago, but Coach Olson getting down, getting back up.
Yeah, he went to the Final Four. He also went to the Final Four when he coached at Iowa. And he's a dynasty builder. He did it at Iowa, and he did it at U of A.
Loosening that collar, Al. He's getting ready for business now as Duke has the ball in a one-point lead. Arizona led by eight in the first half, led by one at halftime.
Mason reached in.
Harvey Mason, who is a very important part of this Arizona team. He's been troubled with a knee problem. An accomplished musician and composer, Harvey Mason. Dad's a graduate of the New England Conservatory of Music. He's from a family of musicians.
I think he wrote that music that Luke was just dancing to.
It could have been.
He said, I wish I could get rid of this leg cast.
They're just happy to have him back. Luke was saying he wants to only get him about 2 or 3 minutes a game. The last thing he wants to do is get the knee tired because that just hinders the recovery process.
Nice color.
State of the art brace.
Big hit.
Hurley, pressure on the ball.
Want to get it down to Williams if possible. There it is. Should be two. Forget about it. Nice block by Allah. Watch Abdel Nabi on this block. That inside position. There he goes up. All leather. Too much hands that time, I believe, on Davies. Oh, David.
And that'll bring the ball inbound to Arizona again. Ryan Davis getting the foul call. He now has two. Duke really turns it up a notch on defense at crunch time. Hurley was in position. Boosler protesting a call against him, but the ball turns over now to the Blue Devils. Coach Olson sees his Wildcats now down by three as Duke looks to extend its lead.
Mr. GQ, you got to fix your collar there. Look, get that collar fixed, Luke. Bobby, your wife will get after you. Your eight grandchildren.
The Duke dominance, 55 straight victories at home against non-conference opponents. McCaffrey down to Abdel Nabi, stripped by Boosler. 6-6, he leads the break.
Nice pass, touch pass, excellent.
And a foul call will send Ed Stokes to the free throw line. The big 6'11 freshman. You mentioned his best pal is George Raveling, the Southern California coach's son. They played together in high school.
Watch this pass here going in. Nice flip pass. You got to remember, Bricky is 6 inches shorter than Stokes. So if the guy gets inside position like he did that time, not much you can do but put Mr. Ed Stokes on the foul line. He has endurance. He's physical. He can run. Three schools he had it down to, or he didn't go to, he visited, was Syracuse, UCLA, and Louisville. But he took the Wildcats.
Dad's an orthopedic surgeon, Ed Stokes, at the free throw line. In fact, his dad was a standout player for the Indiana State Sycamores a few years before Larry Bird got there. What's the ruling now? The basket's not good?
Luke's sitting on the scorer's table. Coach K standing up down his end. See Luke sitting on the table. There's Coach K in the bottom of the screen. That's Lenny Wirtz. Been around a long time. Never loses his cool.
The two are on the board. I don't know if they're coming off. 58-57 on the scoreboard as Lenny Wirtz checks it. Jim Reif, that was the official that Krzyzewski went after at the end of the first half.
Coach K wants an explanation. Now, if they talk to one coach, they got to speak to both.
They get Stokes, gets the free throw, and it's tied up 58-all with 9:50 to play in the game.
They are now using a matchup on Henderson with a diamond zone. See Henderson? He's being shadowed by Mason. See him out there?
Finally, Leitner's Stokes run. He's been quiet. He now has just 4 points for the day.
It's now or never for Christian Leitner. You've got to remember, Christian has four fouls. They'll move him down low to try to pick up the fifth. Trying to kick that ball into Ed Stokes. Let's see what Christian Leitner does with Stokes. Stokes is down low. See him? Nice steal by Bobby. Kick it over to Henderson. No, Bobby takes it himself.
Bobby Hurley with a steal and a breakaway. And Duke with a 4-point lead. Hurley scored 5 points.
Not a must basket, but an important one right now. Williams are bouncing each other.
Boosler gets the rebound, and Arizona gets the roll, and they're back to within two. 8:40 as you see to play in the game. Don Crickey with Coach Al McGuire and Steve Jones at Cameron Indoor Stadium, Duke University, where the Blue Devils in Arizona are matched up. Down low to Crickey. And a foul on Brian Williams of the Wildcats.
Time. Duke is so well coached. when you put a Mickey Mouse defense on him. They got man-to-man on Henderson, and they're playing the diamond zone in the back, and they're destroying the diamond zone. They're attacking that zone 2-1-1. The baseline man's free. Watch Mickey on a baseline here. That's against the zone. Here's another angle on it. See, they're boxing that out. No one's covering the baseline because the diamond's 1-2-1. A box is 2-2. The shadow, the chaser's man-to-man on Henderson. They might call it off now because Duke scored easily the last two times down against it.
Point lead for the Blue Devils. Arizona streaking up court with the ball. Matt Muehlbach has it. Duke has denied Arizona that inside game they were scoring on earlier, but this ball will come inbounds to Arizona.
The reason Matt Muehlbach was sitting out, he also has four personal fouls. Two guys out there, Christian Laettner and Matt Muehlbach, are the only ones that can be put out for the ball.
Duke has taken away the what has been brilliant three-point shooting in recent games at Arizona.
Yeah, they're paying the price underneath. They're getting pounded underneath.
Stokes up in the air. Inbounds to Duke.
Coach K wants him to go slow. Many touches this time down. Let's analyze the D. Let's all take a look at it. This time the D is man to man. Man to man, sloughing off the weak side.
Clean block by Stokes as Laettner goes down and no foul call. Rolled a clean block by Wirtz, who was right on the play. Down low it goes to Brian Williams, and he dips it in with the left hand. And it's a three-point game, Blue Devils. 15 points for sophomore Brian Williams.
Looks like it's going to be a photo. Looks like a white knucklet down to the wire. Christian Laettner got to stay in the game, but that's important. Too much hands on Williams.
Look at big Brian Williams indeed for pushing.
That would be one and one, Don.
It's his third.
Fouls on number 21, Brian Williams.
This is the time where Laettner drove towards the middle here. This is about a minute and a half ago. They doubled down on him, called digging. No call. I agree with it.
Laettner has become the cornerstone of the Duke team as just a sophomore, replacing Danny Ferry as the leader. Last year, Laettner was beneficiary of all the double and sometimes triple teams that were thrown against Ferry. This year, Laettner has been getting all the defensive attention.
The best athlete in the Blue Devils is Robin Frick. He's on the bench right now, getting a blow.
.16 to go as Duke again opens up a five-point lead, and we'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Tom Brokaw goes behind the scenes with President Bush to give you a rare portrait of a day in the life of the White House. A primetime NBC News special, Wednesday.
Did you feel like your long-distance telephone company applied undue pressure to sign you up? Call Carolina Telephone Long Distance and we'll pay to switch you over. If you don't like the home team service, we'll pay to switch you back.
Some long distance telephone connections leave a lot to be desired.
On the other hand, some are perfectly clear. Call Carolina Telephone Long Distance to switch over and see, or hear. If you don't like the home team service, we'll pay to switch you back.
GE Capital Mortgage Insurance is proud to sponsor WPTF-TV's Unsung Heroes, a local celebration of Black History Month.
Some people call us guerrilla television, gonzo television, tabloid television. This show is rampant anarchy. When you peel away the layers of the story, when it comes down to its one-on-one, it comes down to the heartbeat of the story, that's when it gets real good.
Guts TV.
Weeknights at 7:30.
I'm Mark Barger. Join me tonight for Newsbeat 28 Sports.
College basketball is brought to you by the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer. By BASF, the spirit of innovation. by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And by Budweiser, the king of beers. Remember, know when to say when.
Next weekend on NBC Sports, more top college basketball. The current number one team in the country, Missouri, goes to Notre Dame. That's next Saturday at 2:30 Eastern time. And on Sunday, it's back to Duke, where the Tar Heels of North Carolina come in after hammering Duke by 29 points earlier this year. It'll be the rematch next Sunday on NBC. Right now, Arizona down by 5 after leading much of the game. Muehlbach has been cut off from the three-point line.
Arizona's playing with one guard, four baseline men. They'll charge that one to Allah.
Mitchell's calling a very tight game inside. There has been a lot of pushing and shoving. The big men looking for position.
Well, if anything, that painted area should become a trapezoid like they do in international play. And that's the fourth personal was to take him out, save him to maybe about 4.5 minutes, then throw him back in.
It should come into play. The possession arrow does point to Arizona. Muehlbach loses it falling away. Look at Rook screened away. Now he gets it down low to Williams, who can do some slamming. Can he, this guy?
Well, he wants to make sure he has that inside position.
That high percentage shot right down the hatch. He has 17 points, and it's a three-point game, Duke.
They're trying to get the ball to Christian this time, or out to Henderson from the field. Nice pass. They got it into him. It's not there. They double down, or they call that digging. Digging down.
Good D by Rooks. The body position, Leighton away from the shot. And some sensational Duke shooting in the second half. They were shooting 71% before that shot, 12-17. Williams looks for a guard. He got banged, but he's going to stay in there. 5:55 to play in the game. Arizona with the ball and down by three as Rook spins off. Rebound slapped around. It comes inbound to Duke.
Rooks was a little bit outside his range that time. They take Williams out to check to see if he's injured or not. He'll be back in the minutes. He's a little bit outside his range. Good defense by Leighton to force him out. Then he was doubled down by Bricky from the weak side. Trying to shake Henderson free.
Leitner looks low. They're fronting the big men down off the baseline out of the Arizona defenders. Now the rebound comes down to freshman Ed Stokes. Looks for the outlet, and he finds Muehlbach. Long lead to Wayne Womack. Down low to Rooks. Guys had that sweet touch off the glass. It's a one-point game, Blue Devils.
Almost got to go to his own going down to the wire, Coach K. They just got too many guys on that baseline. Good game.
Announcing three ways Oldsmobile's owner satisfaction plan gives you a big edge. One, if you don't still love your new Olds after 30 days or 1,500 miles, we'll let you do something no one else does. Return it. Two, unlike some warranties, Olds covers just one part. This is the part. Three, Olds now offers roadside assistance at a very convenient time, around the clock. The Oldsmobile Edge, extra satisfaction at no extra cost.
Once there were a few proud men of adventure, men of courage, men who knew the meaning of honor. There still are the Marines. We're looking for a few good men.
Whenever I used to watch TV, my brother Tom would always flip me out. Then we got this Magnavox smart window TV that lets Tommy flip through all the channels. And I could keep watching what I want to.
Now I can see what I've been missing.
And that's quite a lot.
I've tried it. Now I believe it. Denerex Tingles tells me it's doing more. Head and shoulders, no tingle.
Both have dandruff medicine, but Denerex adds both an extra anti-itch medicine and conditioner, too.
Goodbye, Head and Shoulders. Hello, Denerex.
I'm Deborah Norville. Coming up tonight on NBC Nightly News, the latest on elections in Nicaragua. Hundreds of thousands have turned out, though in some areas voting has been marred by violence. President Bush and West Germany's Chancellor Kohl discuss the new role of a unified Germany. Plus, we'll have news of a defective heart valve that has already left hundreds dead. Coming up on NBC Nightly News.
The last time Arizona and Duke played a year ago in the Meadowlands of New Jersey, Christian Laettner, a freshman then, missed the front end of a 1-1. It would have given Duke a chance to tie the game, but his teammates and Coach K were over quickly to tell him there'll be more days and good ones. And this game today could go down to a 1-1 at the buzzer, or a shot at the buzzer, as we have a one-point game. Duke, Abdelnaby rejected. Rebound to Wayne Womack. As Duke does such a great job contesting the ball, even when the defender comes down with it. Arizona down by a point. Duke with a heated up defense now. The tight man down low. Stokes rejected. Foul call.
Always remember this. The best way to feed a pivot is to feed it from a high pivot. And that last time there, that was clinic.
That looked like a good block, Elb. See if the bricky got him with the body. It sure looked like a clean
block. Sean Brooks gets it high, feeds it down low to Stokes.
I mean, what did Bricky do wrong?
Well, it's too much contact down low. There's just too much hips in there.
Coach K has been in repose the second half after that outbreak at the end of the first half when he protested what he thought was an over-the-back call that really wasn't called and allowed Brian Williams to score the go-ahead points.
In a game like this that's close, coaches that are great, like both of these coaches, they try to keep their composure because they know now a mistake will mean the game. And you're saying, hey, what's the score? What's the time? How many timeouts? Which way is the arrow pointing? Do I have a different matchup? That's what the coaches that have stood the test of time. Now you don't whip your ball players anymore. Now you hug them. Always the last 4 minutes in the game, you hug them. The first 36 minutes, you put them to the whip.
And with those two free throws, Stokes gives the Arizona Wildcats a 68-67 lead. Laettner defended very well by Sean Rooks.
Henderson three. Nope, we might come down.
Arizona with a very tight man defense.
Plenty of time up, setting up a new offensive set. There's 17 on the shot clock.
4:10 to play. Rebound comes down to Stokes. He is a standout in his first year in major college basketball. Yulbach having problems getting his shot. He's a three-point stroker, but hasn't been there today. He hasn't been able to get it off. Lead to Stokes and a foul call. It's going to go on Arizona. Abdelnaby would be out if it was on him, but he went to the deck, and the rule was that Stokes pushed off. Did you see just his second?
I don't know on this play here. Let's see. Yep, he's right. Stokes did push him off, the inside arm. I didn't like the side of the court that Ala was coming around. Always come around on the baseline. Force your offensive man into the middle where you can get help. On the baseline, you can't get help. Big foul shots. Can get them back the lead right here. Both teams in a 1-1. Oh, country club.
That ties it up at 68. Abdelnaby having an improving season. His point per game average keeps going up. It's almost to 15 now.
He's become mature.
And
comes the man that could decide the game, Brian Williams. Does everything down low, he has his own way. He'll probably foul out both Ala and Christian in the next 2 minutes.
3:45 to play. Rooks puts it up. Falling away jumper. He knocks it down. The big sophomore with a velvet touch. 15 points for Sean Rooks and a one-point lead for Arizona.
Those big guys on Duke got to play some D. They don't. I think they're afraid of fouling out.
Hurley drives and dishes, but Laettner can't get it down, and Williams rips off the rebound.
Get it to your quarterback. Settle down. Wait for your big men to go down.
Womack is a role player and a very good one. He won't fire unless he's wide open. Rooks can't get it to work. Laettner clears the defensive board for the Blue Devils. Up court to Hurley. Has been the quarterback of this team since the day he walked down the court as a freshman. Last September.
Luke saying, now be a little bit more patient. Let's take a couple of touches more this time. Make sure we get it down low, deep. If possible, we want Williams to have it. There he is coming across. There he is. Nice feet by Allah. Too much hands. Goes to Pine City.
That is the game ender for Ala Abdul Nabi. He hears that woeful bail of the horn.
See, he came around the wrong side. I told him earlier you should come along the baseline side. Yes, Ala, you had too much hands on him, but you played a great game. He's definitely a Sweet 16 team, and it could be. It just could be for Duke. 4 out of the last 5 years in the Mile High City in Denver, Colorado.
We talked in the opening, Al, about a shootout, and that's what has come down to. Al Abdul Nabi gunned in 17 points for the Blue Devils of Duke, but now his fifth foul sends him to the bench.
Next, as I told you, Williams will foul out late for Christian Layton.
Ryan Williams having a big day for the Arizona Wildcats. That was his 18th point he just put in. He also has 9 rebounds.
My half-hour special before the year, I picked U of A number one in the country, but I thought Mills was going to be playing. In my hour special, I'll tell you that right before the final of the NCAA on that Sunday.
Last year, last season, Arizona went to the Sweet 16 of the tournament after winning the Pac-10 and was sent home by UNLV. Leitner goes hard, and he's hit hard. He'll go to the free throw line.
If he's thinking, Don, about what you talked about before. Arizona, when he took the shot in the Meadowlands.
Right. Well, I think now he's a seasoned veteran.
Christian Layton at the line for Duke.
He's hit. Kept his eyes up. Follow through. He had a flat game. I personally think he makes it.
Well, he has just 4 points today, 1 of 9 shooting. His offense has been off in recent games, but his rebounding has been up.
He's tough, but the key to his toughness is the mental toughness. The body hasn't come yet. It'll come next couple of years, 3-4 years.
Leitner gets them both, and it's a 1-point game, Arizona, as Kurt Krzyzewski reflecting the tension of this game. Arizona in from the west, playing a tremendous game. Williams can't get it to go. Rebound is 6-4 Robert Bricky. And he looks for Hurley, who will run the offense. Oklahoma with a commanding lead over number one Missouri.
And he goes to Pine City, Matt Muehlenbach. And out will come from the bench, Othick, Matt Othick, Matt for Matt. It's a little bulldog, Matt Muehlenbach, but a big competitor. Here he catches Christian down low.
Well, he had no complaints about that call, Al. As he is.
Well, I think the game has been reffed excellent with all those bodies out there, all those battleships.
Big ones. Brooks and Leitner both playing with 4 personal fouls. Christian Leitner.
Turnabout's fair play last year with 1 second left. He missed the front end of the 1-1, which meant the game. Coach K came over to him and says, "That's okay, son. You'll win a lot of games for us in the next 3 years."
Right now, 4 straight free throws. The last 2 trips down. Leitner has given Duke the lead, 73-72. 2 minutes and 5 seconds left to play. As again, Othick has to work up against full court pressure from Hurley.
Trying to front those big men down low. Gives him the inside position. Big steal by Henderson.
Big steal. Henderson down low. Oh, the roll. And Duke goes in front 75-72.
He didn't put that ball up high enough, but he got the break.
Nothing there for Rooks, who defended by Leitner. John Rooks with a terrific shooting touch. Here is Buechler pulling up. And he gets it down, and Duke's lead is cut to 1 as time becoming a major factor now. We're down to 1:15 to play in the game. Duke holding on to a 1-point lead over Arizona.
No cosmetics now. Both coaches are in the game, not working the referees. Just want to make the offensive and defensive calls properly.
There were 10 lead changes in the first half, at least that many in the second. For the game, we're told 23 lead changes.
Oh, you can't let them have that one.
traffic leads the break. But now the loop lead goes down low and it's intercepted by Brian Davis with 44 seconds to go.
I'd work the clock, create Arizona to foul you. Spread out. Spread out. Got a foul right away, Arizona. Come on, go out there and foul right away. Right away, right away. Williams, get out there. You're letting too many ticks go off. Good. Good. You're only down one. He makes both. All you need is one possession with 22 seconds left in the clock.
So the shootout will go down to the wire. Our thanks to producer Tommy Roy, director John Gonzalez, executive producer of NBC Sports Terry O'Neill, coordinating producer of basketball John Filippelli. Now thanks to NBC statistician Elliot Taub. We have 22 seconds to go and we come back. This one will be decided.
She's all ours.
Going into business. Got something new. Gonna pay me time. Red, white, and blue. I'm coming through this bar.
Nice place.
How about some customers?
Ladies' night.
Great place, guys. Who did your decorating?
Finally, there's a minivan for kids with parents. Cool. And let's face it, we all have them.
Yeah.
The all-new Oldsmobile Silhouette. Talking radical concept here. Your own window seat. Room for lots of things. And neat stuff to keep your parents from bugging you on long trips. Besides, Silhouette makes them look cool.
Right. Yeah. This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
Ready, dudes?
And they need all the help they can get.
Yeah.
This is the new generation of Oldsmobile.
Another day comes to a close. And tonight, some people will rest a little easier because helping to protect their automobiles, their homes, their families is an independent insurance agent who compared the options and recommended Kemper. Kemper Insurance, coming through for more than 75 years. After all, if you can't sleep, you can't dream.
The Chevrolet most valuable players for the game are Phil Henderson of Duke and Brian Williams of Arizona. Chevrolet will donate $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund, reward outstanding students for their academic achievements, and also to assist those in financial need. 22 seconds to go. A game that has seen 23 lead changes, and the man who's made it happen with his sharp shooting, particularly in the second half, is at the line. Phil Henderson.
They're breaking the rhythm of the shooter, making that substitution, and you got to remember now, the arrow favors Arizona. I take him back out. You're really putting pressure on Phil Henderson out there. You're cooling him off. I complain about it, Coach K. The arrow favors Arizona. Both teams have three timeouts remaining. Pretty tough going to that up back. Hey, I wouldn't get that line. Knight backs off the line again. This favors Arizona, but that's a senior out there. He's been through it before.
Henderson with 27 points and Duke with a 2-point lead. Arizona has some of the best 3-point shooters in the country, but today they've been unable to trigger their shot. The Duke defense has been too tight at the perimeter. Back to Cameron in a moment.
Announcing three ways Oldsmobile's owner satisfaction plan gives you a big edge. One, if you don't still love your new Olds after 30 days or 1,500 miles, we'll let you do something no one else does. Return it. Two, unlike some warranties, Olds covers just one part. This is the part. Three, Olds now offers roadside assistance at a very convenient time, around the clock. The Oldsmobile Edge, extra satisfaction at no extra cost.
This is the new generation of Olds.
At BASF, we don't make the plane. We make it lighter. We don't make the lotion. We make it smoother. We don't make the dress. We make it brighter. We don't make the carpet, we make it tougher. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF, the spirit of innovation.
There's a motor oil that talks about quality. Always has, always will. Well, Valvoline makes the highest quality motor oil recommended by any automobile manufacturer. Oh yeah, unlike the competition, Valvoline also makes the motor oil used by 7 out of 10 Indy 500 crew chiefs. That's 7 out of 10 Indy crew chiefs over the last 10 years. People who know use Valvoline.
With Coach Al McGuire and Steve Jones, this is Don Kroeke back at Cameron Indoor Stadium. 22 seconds to play in the game. A year ago, it was Arizona beating Duke by 2 points. And now Henderson with a two-point lead. Gives the Blue Devils a three-point lead. Henderson, the leading scorer in the game with 28 points.
They go down low and then try to kick it back out. Ozick.
They need the three. Boosler fires. Rooks. Had the ball, lost it, it'll come in. They're going to call a jump. If it is, it's an Arizona possession.
No, it's a one-and-one. No, it's a one-and-one. It's a one-and-one foul. 12 seconds left in the game.
They'd almost rather not have the one-and-one, get a chance to bring it inbounds and shoot the three.
Duke called the timeout. Each team now has two remaining. I believe that there should only be two timeouts a half. First half, second half, for each club, and no carryovers. That's the way they do it in the international rules. Let's widen the three-point area, stretch the three-point shot a little bit further, and make it a 30-second clock. Then we're set for the next century.
Bill Henderson now was called for the foul, and a very wise move by Henderson because it sends Arizona to the line to try the one and bonus. And if they succeed at both ends, the best they could do would be behind by a point with 12 seconds to play. See if they have some trick shot up their sleeve.
Well, if they make the first one, they should maybe miss the second one on purpose with Coach Luke putting in a lot of height down low and look for the rebound. Now, you got to catch the rim on that second shot. If it just hits the backboard without the rim, it doesn't count. So let's see if that happens. That means they make the first shot.
Right.
Now, the second shot, they miss on purpose, but it must catch part of the rim. And what you do, you overload with your tall guys looking to get the rebound and have a putback and into OT.
Three-point lead for Duke. Henderson's been the difference with his brilliant shooting in the second half. Rooks, a sophomore, has been very consistent player. He scored 15 for Arizona, has hit three or four from the line.
Here comes that height I was talking about. Stokes, he wants in. 6'11" freshman. They probably take out Womack. No, they wouldn't let him in. It's too late. But Womack's a skier anyway. He's 6'8". Nice and quiet in here.
Rebound comes down to Brian Davis, and he is quickly fouled with 9 seconds to go. So Duke can slam the lid on now. After the Blue Devils trailed by 8 in the first half, we're down by 1 at halftime. A game that has seen 23 lead changes. 9 seconds to go, and Duke sends a sophomore to the line to try to ice it.
Looks like it's going to be 56 in a row against non-ACC teams at Cameron.
7 years it's been since a non-ACC team has defeated Duke here in Cameron. Coach K is a wide-eyed afternoon.
Luke wants a timeout to ice him again. This is a younger man shooting. This is not Henderson shooting now. This is a younger guy. He's only a sophomore.
Brian Davis, a 6'6 sophomore, averaging 5 points a game. He had one big game when Duke held on to beat Georgia Tech here. He scored a career-high 16 points. Davis has 8 points today, all in the first half.
Plays two positions. He plays the off-guard, the number two position, or plays the number three, which is a small forward.
Next Saturday on NBC Sports at 2:30 Eastern time, the number one ranked Missouri Tigers in danger of losing that top ranking, trailing Oklahoma at the moment, will go into South Bend to play the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, a team that must battle now every game to try and make the tournament. Then on Sunday, the rematch. Earlier this season, North Carolina blew out Duke at Chapel Hill, a few miles away, winning by 29 points. And next next Sunday at 2 o'clock Eastern Time. It'll be the rematch, Duke and North Carolina. But right now, Lute Olson, coach of Arizona. I don't know what you can coach your team here, Al, about how to get the opposition to miss a free throw.
Well, he's doing everything humanly possible. He's taking all the percentages just like a baseball manager. I believe it looks like Missouri will lose to Oklahoma. I believe that Missouri will not lose the number one rating.
Very interesting. Well, if they do, it'll be the 14th time this year there's been a change in the number one rating in one of the polls.
And I also believe the number one conference in the country this year is the Big Eight.
Very good. With Missouri, Kansas, and Oklahoma, and Kansas State, a team that's liable maybe not to win it all, but they're going to send somebody home.
And Oklahoma State is tough, too.
They are. Ryan Davis at the line.
Big.
They'll not catch Duke now. 4-point lead with 9 seconds to go.
Good game. Good reaction by the students. It's nice to see a place where the students have the best seats.
Duke defense took away the Arizona three-point shot. They've been, the other night, Friday night at Stanford, they hit 7 of 9 three-point shots to Arizona. Today they've made 1 of 6. They have only 6 tries. Here comes one, but it'll be too little too late. Offit fires off the mark. Back up and down by Rooks. And at the buzzer, it's a 2-point game. So Duke does indeed avenge the 2-point loss of a year ago in the Meadowlands of New Jersey, rallying today to beat a very tenacious Arizona team, 78-76. Now for Al McGuire and Steve Jones, this is Don Cricky. Stay tuned for tonight's programming on NBC, including Disney's animated classic, Alice in Wonderland. Then Robert Mitchum stars in a special movie, A Family for Joe.
The preceding has been a presentation.